had a project, 16-year project, and they produced it. Something like the Quran. Now, my brethren among you here, anybody who can read Arabic? Can you read Arabic? You can read Arabic. Not the Quranic Arabic, generally Arabic. The Quranic Arabic, as we know, nicely, nice, bold, round hand, is much easier to read. Anybody else? I have that you can read. I want somebody else also. I want two volunteers. You are the one. Anybody else who can read Arabic? You will. Right. This is the New Testament in Arabic. The so-called Injil, what they call their Injil, which is not Injil. This is the Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. You see, they're pushing it down your throat as an Injil. This is in Arabic. They have this in 2,000 different languages. They have 11 different Arabic Bibles for the Arabs. Different dialects, different scripts. No excuse that they say, well, I can't read. This script is a bit difficult, like us, for us. This is difficult. You see, most of us, you can't read this. Therefore, I said, now, somebody who can read Arabic, not the Quran. Quranic Arabic, alhamdulillah, most of us can read. Because it was Dhamma, Fatha, Kathra at the right places and nice, bold handwriting. We can read. This one is a bit more specialized for the Arabs. Come, Akhi, I want you to read this to the people. This is the Gospel of St. John, chapter 19. I want you to read this. This chapter here. You read it into the mic.
الإصحاح السابع عشر. تكلم يسوع بهذا ورفع عينيه نحو السماء وقال: أيها الآب، قد أتت الساعة، مجد ابنك ليمجدك ابنك أيضا، إذ أعطيته سلطانا من كل جسد ليعطي حياة أبدية لكل من أعطيته، وهذه هي الحياة الأبدية، أن يعرفوك أنت الإله الحقيقي وحدك ويسوع المسيح الذي أرسلته. أنا مجدتك على الأرض، العمل الذي أعطيتني لأعمل قد أكملته، والآن مجدني أنت أيها الآب عند ذاتك بالمجد الذي كان لي عندك قبل كون العالم.
Right. You see, with this, they can't catch the Arab Muslims. It's so insipid. You know, it's to the Arab Muslim, he has a good laugh. He says, this guy, they don't know how to write, you know, Arabic. They laugh at this. The language is all like, you know, a children's language. So they says, no, it's not catching fish. The Muslim, you can't catch them. So they produce this one here. They produce this one here, the New Testament, in Quranic Arabic. They have now done this in the Quranic Arabic. Beginning, every chapter begins, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So as soon as you read Bismillah, immediately you are attracted. Say, well, this must be Allah's Kalam or some kitab or something or the other. You start reading. Ah, the calligraphy is also the Quranic calligraphy. The designs are also Islamic designs. Every chapter, Islamic designs. And begins, it says here, Babu Sakina Maqdisi. See, we have the Quran, the surahs, Makkiya Madaniya. So you're used to that, Makkiya Madaniya. Why does this surah was revealed in Makkah or it was in Medina? So it's a Makkiya Madaniya. So there's a Maqdisi. Maqdisi means Baitul Muqaddas in Jerusalem. But it's a Maqdisi. You think something similar to ours, catching fish. See, familiarity. Now, come, Akhi. I want you to read this as you would the beautiful manner in which you read the Quran. We want you to read also the usual, please. You know, nothing extraordinary, but usual what you read, the way you read the Quran. I want you to try and read this. Into the mic.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قل يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله حقا فآمنوا بي ولا تخافوا إن لكم عند الله جنات نزلا فلأسبقنكم إلى الله لعدها لكم ثم لاتينتنينكم نزلة أخرى وإنكم لتعرفون السبيل إلى قبلتي العليا. فقال له توما الحواري مولانا إنا لا نملك من ذلك علما.
You see, if you were fiddling with your radio and Monte Carlo radio is broadcasting this, and you just happen, the man starts, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Won't you be caught up? It's a qiraat, you know. And the guy starts. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Any objections? No, it's Quranic. These are words, phrases borrowed from the Quran. Bismillah, borrowed from the Quran. Catching Muslim fish. New deceit. New deceit. Ever increasing in their sicknesses. Catching Muslim fish. Catching Arabs. Catching the Arabs out now. What about the Pakistani? What about the Bangladeshi? What about the African Muslim? What about the Malay? Easier fish. We are easier fish. You can't make us. Tuma. Tuma. Tuma means Thomas. No, I think maybe he didn't, you know, pronounce properly. You still listen, keep on listening. You don't say Tuma. This is talking about Thomas. There's no Thomas in the Quran. No, he still catches. But he's reading so nicely, so beautifully. It sounds like the Quran, the rhyme and the rhythm of the Quran, like Abdul Samad Abdul Basit. Deceits, new deceits. My dear brothers and sisters, what do you do? What do you do? You gonna fight them? No. We can't fight and win. But the battle is on. Allah reminds us, eternal reminder, they'll never, never be satisfied with you, O Muslims, unless you follow their brand of religion. You want peace? Opt to get out of Islam. Become Christians if you want peace. Or change them. You get changed, you become Christian, or make them Muslims. There's no other way. There's no sitting on the fence anymore. They won't leave you in peace. That now look, I want to be, I read the tasbih and I read salat and you know, I'm a good Muslim, I go for hajj. That won't save you. It won't save your children. Wallah, it won't save your children. New deceits. They come to you, new methods of propagation. Previously, they came to us, they said, you know, Muhammad was an imposter. He was a false prophet. The Quran is a fabrication. Muhammad copied it from the Jews and the Christians. Muhammad has so many wives. He spread his religion at the point of the sword. That didn't gather honey. See, because now you're on the defensive. You want to fight back? Not so anymore. Now they come to you. Assalamu alaikum. Ya Haji Sahib, Ya Akhi, Muhammad, Ahmad, whoever you are. Can I have a few minutes with you? It's a pleasure. Come. Most especially is a white man, and if he's got his wife with him, we melt quicker.